So this is what I'm trying to say. If you've ever had a dream where there was an intimate advance made on you in the dream, it was a demonic dream, not a good one. And one of the most evident ways to know that someone is dealing with a spirit spouse is that they have those types of defiled dreams. I'm going to give you a couple of symptoms and some other things that I have found that the spirit, that these spirits do. And then I'm going to explain incubus, succubus, and spirit spouse. I'm going to describe them so that you can understand what they mean. Now, first I want to tell you a quick story. I was actually in New York 2 years ago. And while I was in New York, I began to preach on deliverance. And as I was preaching on deliverance, a little girl walks up to me. She comes up to the stage. And when she comes up to the stage, I'm thinking she has a prayer request. So I lean over to hear what she's saying. The music was very loud. And when I lean over, she looks at me and she goes, "Satan hates you." Immediately, I recognized that a demon was manifesting through the little girl. So this removes all our theology that children cannot have demons. Also, the fact that most of the deliverances that Jesus did were on children, as far as the ones that were described to us. So anyway, what happens is this provoked me. And I decided we're going to cast out devils now. So I stopped teaching like I'm doing now. And I just began to go and lead the people into deliverance prayers. So as we're doing deliverance prayers, demons, they begin to manifest all over the place. They're manifesting everywhere. Everywhere that you could look, everybody was manifesting. The church I'm in, it is it's a Nigerian church. And so as demons are manifesting, this young man who looked like he was probably in his early or late 20s, he starts to beat on his chest like this. And as he's beating on his chest, I knew a demon was manifesting. And then we began to deal with this spirit. Well, the demon says, "You can't cast me out. I'm his wife." So next question I ask is, how did you enter this young man? Now, let me also insert this. This is really good, by the way. I'm saying that because it's the anointing is teaching us. So I'm actually complimenting God. I'm going to say something that is a major error in the prophetic or in the deliverance movement today, but you tend to see it more with individuals who don't really do deliverance a lot. They say things like, "You will never encounter a time where you should not use the gifts of the Spirit to do deliverance." Now, I tell people this all the time. I believe in deliverance in every way Jesus exercised it. But here's the problem. To say that every time there's a demon, that you're guaranteed to get a word of knowledge, that you're guaranteed to have the Lord give you the discerning of spirits will function, is full of pride. And the reason why is because Jesus had to ask Legion's name. If Jesus himself had to ask, that means that he wasn't getting from the gifts of the Spirit a discernment about his name or what he was. Jesus did deliverance by his authority in that moment. Okay? So this is what I'm presenting to you. The Bible says all the works that Jesus did that volumes of books could be written and the world could not contain them all. This means that the Holy Spirit saw fit that every deliverance account we see in Scripture wasn't all of them. He gave us the ones we needed. What this means is that may not have been the only time Jesus asked the Spirit's name. That was the one time we were given. Oh my goodness, I feel God. But I'm also going to add the balance. That doesn't mean we do it every time. So that means when we do deliverance, every single time we do deliverance, we don't have to ask the Spirit's name. This means sometimes we do deliverance, demons will come out by our teaching. Sometimes when we do deliverance, they'll come out in the spiritual warfare prayer. Sometimes they'll come out at the laying on of hands. Sometimes they'll come out when we begin to renounce and repent. If people will start having demons leave them just from repenting and renouncing. There'll be times where the fire of God is moving in the worship and demons start coming out while the worship is going. Right? There'll be times where spirits are coming out, right? Just off of what's it, just spiritual warfare prayer. Then there'll be times where we'll get words of knowledge and we'll call out a certain function of a spirit. And then the discerning of spirits may function and we'll highlight the name of a demon and command it to come out. But there's many ways it'll come out. So we have to be open to all the realms of deliverance, all the ways that God does deliverance. So in this case, I needed to ask the name. And so he said, I'm his wife. I said, how'd you enter this man? And he said, through pornography. I've done spiritual warfare of people that a spirit was blocking them from pregnancy. I've done spiritual warfare prayer. I remember someone came, they flew into our ministry from Dallas. When they came in from Dallas, we started praying for them, and nothing was moving in the deliverance session. We could not figure out, because we can't do it in a cookie-cut way. It's not the same every time. And as we were trying to figure it out, I had to back up and say, Holy Spirit, why are we not getting anywhere with this deliverance? And he said, I want you to ask her about the dream she had the other day. And I said, okay. And so we kind of regroup, and I'm like, I feel led to ask you, what dream have you recently had? And this is what she said. I had a dream that there was a spirit, and this spirit, it had a canvas, like it was painting. And once again, I'm going to say this very PG. But once again, I told you, the enemy's dreams, they defile people. So sometimes describing them is very difficult to do, because we're trying to say things that are defiled in a very holy way. Well, the spirit was drawing her female organ, and it was painting a serpent going into it. And then it looked at her and said, you cannot, she had been trying to get deliverance for years, and the spirit said, you cannot cast me out. And it said, because me and you have a covenant. Now, when this happened, the Lord spoke to me, and a verse came in my spirit in Job. And the verse was, I will make a covenant with my eyes that I will not look upon a young lady. What does that mean? That means evil covenants can be made even with certain body parts. That means sometimes we're breaking a covenant. We're not just, watch this, we're not just dismantling an evil altar. Sometimes the covenant was made with a physical body part. Y'all don't believe me. I just showed you in scripture that a holy covenant could be made with our eyes. That we would decide to not use our eyes for evil. When the enemy establishes an evil covenant, that part of the man becomes captive to the use of the enemy, and that part of them begins to be used as an instrument for the demonic, for evil. This is good. So in my experience, we've cast out devils that have blocked pregnancies, and it's been the spirit spouse. I've noticed that a common denominator, now this is not biblical, this is experience that I'm sharing now. I know it's the common denominator between women who have stillborns, women that deal with a lot of miscarriages and things like that. Many of them needed deliverance from the spirit spouse. I've discovered that in my experience, these spirits hate children bearing. I've discovered also another thing these spirits fight against is marriage. These spirits hate marriage. Now, there are many spirits that fight marriage, just like there are many sicknesses and diseases and things like that. So I'm not saying this is the only one, but one of the number one spirits that fight marriages, even people getting married. Like, for example, I've done deliverance on people where after the deliverance, they'll tell me, my aunt's single, this person's single, everyone in my family line is single, like everybody. And many times it's connected to the spirit spouse.